So this is kind of a reincarnation of a video that I do every year, a couple of times a year. In our city, they do a thing called a free giveaway weekend a couple of times a year, spring and fall. Basically, it's kind of to prevent stuff from hitting the landfill. For people that have stuff that they want to get rid of but can't be bothered to go to the thrift store, don't have enough stuff to have their own yard sale, basically you just put it out in the curb with the sign that says free. People come by if they want it, they take it, if not, whatever, right? And a lot of stuff changes hands and doesn't go in the garbage, so that's a good thing. So me being the cheap guy that you know I am, I always go out, and I found a handful of interesting things, like this little plain old parts case here. I guess technically it's sold as a fishing tackle box, but that's not what I use them for. They're obviously good for keeping parts in, and those are not cheap. The only thing is it's only got three dividers in it, but that's okay. I have stuff that'll fit in there. The latches are all good. Yeah, that's definitely a score. So that's the first thing. Secondly, found another empty growler bottle. These are for refilling with craft beer at your favorite brewery. And as you know, I have several of them. And this one's a bit dusty on the outside, but it's nice and dry and clean and not skanky smelling on the inside. So that should be handy. What else? I got this bag full of cables, which I haven't really actually looked at, but it was just there, so I can always use wires and cables for various things around here. You guys have seen that before. So what do we have? Well, there's a mouse in there, just a cheap little optical mouse, but that's not a bad thing. Power supply, what is this? 12 volts, 3 amps. If it works, that's great. This looks like the base station for a wireless keyboard and mouse, but the keyboard and mouse didn't come with it, so maybe I'll tear that apart one of these days and see what it does. What else we got here? Got a few audio cables, and what is that? That's a VGA cable, that's good. USB, what is this? That is an XM radio branded satellite radio antenna. What's the connector on that? Oh, interesting. I wonder if that connector fits with the SDRs. Hang on. Yeah, these little SDRs. No, it doesn't look like it. No, it's the same connector as that end. So my antenna adapters for the SDR will plug into that. Okay, so I can actually use that. I wonder if I can adapt enough to be able to use it. So satellite radio, I wonder what frequency that is. And that's heavy too. I wonder if I can use that for anything. But regardless, it's got some cable on it, and what is that? That looks like just a male-to-male 3.5-inch. That's good. Is that everything in this bundle? Oh, there's a couple power cords. Oh, a replaceable IEC end. That can be handy. And just another power cord. That's a heavy-duty one, too. Where's the end of that? Yeah, that's good. That'll come in handy. I know, it's just random crap, but you never know when just stuff like this is going to come in handy. And there's a teardown victim. Might do that sooner rather than later. And the last thing that I got is this First Alert rechargeable flashlight. Now, I remember these things from when I was a kid. They recharge like that. You just plug them into the wall and just leave them there on a trickle charge forever, and then when you need it in a power outage or something, just grab it, flick it on, and away you go. Interesting, convenient. Yeah, this is First Alert. That's the same company that makes smoke detectors and fire extinguishers and stuff like that. Now, they don't make this anymore. After a bit of searching around, I found a very similar flashlight to this one, circa 1987, in the Flashlight Museum, of all places. I didn't even know that existed. They claim $5 value. I don't know whether that was what it cost new or what, but yeah. And in the discussion down below, there's a lot of people saying, how do I replace the batteries? So that's interesting. I'm probably going to have the same thing. Is this the same one? No, that's a really small one. Here's a slightly different style and a bit earlier. I think I remember these ones as well from the 70s. Some people again saying that this guy says his still works 5 years ago. A bunch that don't work. Which isn't really a surprise given the age of them. I'm going to guess that these things probably run on NiCads based on the age of them. But let's take a closer look at the one I've got. So how they charge is you just flip that guy out and you plug it into the wall and then you just let it sit there trickle charging forever. Now I've had this thing plugged in for a few hours already and as you can see when I turn it on nothing happens. So either we have battery problems, which is most likely, or the bulb. And apparently, you can just pop the bulb out like that. So, let's take a closer look at that and see what it looks like. The filament appears to be intact, I think. Although, I guess the easiest way to tell is with a meter, isn't it? Yep, that's continuity. So that's not the problem. The problem is, as I expected, somewhere down in here. So do we have a model number on there? Not really, some manufacturing information. Draws 10 milliamps at 120 volts. Plug straight in. Series 3 rechargeable flashlight. Okay. Now let's see if we can pull it apart. There's a seam there. Kind of feels like it should want to come apart. But I don't know if it actually will or not. Huh. There's some promise. Okay. Let's try this new automotive spudger that I got in the last mailbag there. It's not really going in there all that effectively, but once I got that started, it goes in, but it's starting to look like it's, I'll spare you this pain, I think, and I'll just go at it and come back in a second here. Kind of liking the idea of having a non-conductive tool to throw in. Oh, there we go. Okay, we're in. Wow, okay. First thing I see is a bunch of corrosion on the battery terminals here. How did this work? And that goes into that little cavity. So yeah, that causes that little thing to rotate around. So the charging circuit is, it's two diodes in series by the looks of it. Wow, or is that something else? Maybe that's a fuse? I'm not sure. Actually, let's cut that little bit of insulating sleeving out of there so we can see what we're playing with here. Meter in ohms mode. That is 8.2K and it is 8.2K V. So that's not a diode. But this obviously is 4 mega ohms that way and open that way. What? Diode test mode. Yeah. Drop that way, open that way. Okay, so some kind of a resistive fusible element maybe in series with that. And then we have this monstrous weird battery pack. I'm going to guess that there's no voltage in that battery, but I suppose just for fun and games, we could check it. .8 volts. Essentially nothing. Let's see if we can lift it out. Being super gentle, of course. Yeah, so that just cracked right off there. And there's the other terminal soldered on. I wonder what that was originally. Does that mean anything to anybody? 405 or 40S, 1223, 180? But yeah, corrosion and cruft and crud. What's the, does this bulb say what its voltage is? 2.0 volts, 1.2 amps. So apparently this battery is capable of 2 volts. What does that say in there? I think I can see some lettering in there. Lead acid battery. Okay, so it isn't a NiCad as I initially thought. It is a sealed lead acid battery. Which makes sense for 2 volts, I guess, because that's on a 12 volt, or on an automotive battery, lead acid battery, any lead acid battery, really, each cell in the battery is 2 volts. And you charge it at about 2.2 volts. That's the same in the telecom batteries that I deal with at work. That's the same in a car battery, whether it's a 6-volt battery for your old 1950s jalopy, or a standard 12-volt battery, or 24-volt battery system like some commercial vehicles run. Each of the cells is going to be 2 volts. So, I'm a little bit less excited about opening this up, actually. Because it's going to have sulfuric acid inside it, which I don't really want out on my bench. But that was interesting seeing what was inside there. From the, how do we say that, cost-optimized charging system to the interesting little mechanical bits here. That's actually the on-off switch right there. That's mechanically ingenious. I can't imagine that this was designed to last forever. Oh wow, I'm just having a bit of an AVE moment here. Look at the chowdering in there. It looks like somebody went in with, geez, with something and just ground up the plastic. What the hell happened there? Wow. It's a fairly solid plastic that they used, and very solidly, was it? So that was punched in there. That was part of what was holding it. And there's another couple of pins up there. And then these, okay, I snapped the set off there in there. And this set was in those. Okay, so it was just mechanically clipped together. And obviously it was designed to hold this kind of a battery, because you can see the saddles in there. But I don't know what all this business is about in here. Anyway, that was kind of fun. Just to tear down a piece of 70s technology that cost me nothing. So that was also a bonus. And I guess I got a 2-volt light bulb out of the deal. Don't know what I'm going to use a 2-volt light bulb for, but I got one now. I'm going to guess that bulb is fairly bright. I mean, it's an emergency flashlight after all. But we'll see. So I've got my power supply set to 2 volts and current limiting is cranked up to about 2 amps. So we'll see what happens. That's just barely glowing. And it's drawing about 800 and 900 milliamps. That did say 2.0 volts, right? Okay, let's pop that up to 2.5 volts. That's just dim, dim, dim. So there's 4 volts, give or take. That's drawing about 1.3 amps. Turn it up to full, to 5 volts here. Starting to get warm on the fingers. There's an amp and a half, which is what it's rated at. But that's at 5 volts to get that out of it. Wow. That is a nice bright, That is a nice bright bulb though. I'm sure I can find a use for that, especially that it comes with a reflector that matches it. You never know, it could be handy, if nothing else, for a load, for testing things. Oh, have I popped it? Oh, I think I've popped it. I have. Oh well, fun was had, and that's the important thing, right? Thanks for watching. I appreciate you stopping by to see what I'm up to now and again. If you got any comments or questions, do you remember these things? Those of you who are old enough to remember what was happening back in the 70s? Yeah. Let's hear from you down in the comments as usual. Don't be too mean though. I'm fragile. Yeah. Well, thanks for watching. I'll talk to you later.